So I've gone through all the categories of gadgets. So you see that there's a lot of stuff out there that you can add and customize your page to be exactly what you're interested in and what you want to see on your home page every time you go there. So this is like meant to be your personalized home page. It's always going to have what you're interested in right there on it, and you can change it if you want to. So you'll probably want to set google.com/ig as your home page in your browser. That's typically in the preferences, depending on which browser you're using. That is, if you like using iGoogle, I do. The last thing I want to mention is the tabs. So by default, you've got your home tab, and you're adding stuff, and this is what you're going to see every time you go to iGoogle. But you can actually add different tabs. So instead of having every gadget you're interested in on one page, it could get kind of cluttered. So you could add a tab. And one of the really cool things about adding a tab is this I'm feeling lucky option. And basically, I can type in, what am I going to call the tab? Call it movies. And based on that title, Google is going to pull a bunch of different gadgets that I might like. And there we go. It pulled a movie trailers gadget, a Fandango movie lister, rolling movie reviews, Showtimes. Oh, it's actually playing. New York Times movies, DVD releases, Netflix new releases. So that's really cool how you can do that. And probably a good thing, the tabs, almost the way I use them is like categories. So I've got all like movies, or you can create a tab just about news where you can add all the different news sources that you like to use. And maybe you can add a tab just called games. So when I do that, it's gonna give me a bunch of those games that we saw in that fun and game section, like the crossword. That's pretty cool. Hangman, some other things. So keep that in mind that you can create all these tabs, and you don't have to put all your gadgets on one page. And you can see I can go back and forth between them. Home is what you're going to see whenever you go to iGoogle, the first thing you're going to see. So this is where you want to put all your most important stuff, the things you look at all the time. I'm not necessarily going to always be playing games, but when I want to, I can skip straight to this tab. So that is pretty much it. That is how you use iGoogle and can personalize a home page with all these available gadgets, and can make new tabs and do all sorts of stuff. So I definitely recommend checking it out. There's a lot of cool gadgets out there, and it's a real convenient way to organize everything you do on the web anyway. Maybe like look at news and put it all in one place and still have the convenience of Google search bar right there. So that is iGoogle.